Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS, and this week I'm making a passenger station. Now, Walther's makes a really nice passenger station. It's the Union Station, but it's really big, and it's about between $40 and $60, a little bit more than what I wanted to spend and too big for what I was using it for. What I wanted to do was build the B&O station in Pittsburgh. It was located at the stub end of a small yard built in around 1957, and it lasted all the way until the 1990s. Problem is, there wasn't a lot of pictures. Show you one here. Okay. And since there's no commercial kits available, I had to scratch build it. Now, when you're scratch building, it can be kind of intimidating at first. So, the first thing I do is start at the hardest part, and that's the windows. The first thing I did was get a piece of paper and a pencil and draw out the shape of the opening, pretty much a rectangle. Now I knew that there was going to be three double doors that's 7 feet high. There was also one, I would guess probably much a 1 foot divider between the double doors. And that each set was 6 feet wide with the 1 foot opening, or I'm sorry, 1 foot divider. And that gave me 18 and 2 gives me a 20 foot wide opening. And then from there, I worked my way up. And I figured how many feet between the top of the door and the overhang. About 16 feet. Okay, now I have my clear plastic styrene, and I'm going to use the back of my X-Acto blade. The reason why I'm using the back is that so I can kind of scrib a line in here without cutting through it. So I start at the 16 and work my way down. Carefully and slowly. And I'll do 2 passes with it. From here, I'm going to go up 7 feet. And go across. See what I like about this? I didn't have to paint. I didn't have to mask with any tape. And this came out really, really nice. In a little bit, I'm going to cut out a little wider than here. And then that way, if you have some room, when you glue it onto the inside of your building, you won't get any glue on the windows. The more glass that you can have on the outside, the best chance of not getting any glue on the inside. I'll show you what I mean. Here's my finished B&O building. If you look closely, you see how I got a drop of glue in there. Okay? Not happy about it, but at this angle, you can't see it. So what do you think? Now I still got to do the windows for the rest, but I'm going to use just the same technique, except I only need to do like 1 or 2 lines on the plastic that'll be in there. Next I used the 0.080 by 0.080 strip styrene and made 3 pieces. I took them off, assembled it,
use the drop of glue for the corners. And whenever I was finished with that, I placed it on top of just sheet styrene. This was 0.030 in thickness, a little thicker than I normally use, but I want something strong. And I measured that out once it was done. And then just using the same techniques of looking at the picture and figuring, okay, this is about 2 feet wider than that. I measured around, made my cuts. And that's how I came up with the framework. I always use a lot of that strip styrene. I use it to support the roofs. I use it to brace the walls and the floors. Even to accent the roof. One product that I should have used, but I forgot to, is also this clear plastic cement for windows. And that probably would have eliminated that problem that I had. This is a little slower to dry, so give yourself some extra time with this. The sidewalk is just simple styrene. I did the same thing. Used the back of the X-Acto blade. And I just made a line and I kept it, you know, perfect with the ruler. It's all just simply the back. You can make sheet styrene look like almost anything just with the back of the X-Acto blade. Alrighty. Alright guys, I made this whole thing for probably about 10 or 15 bucks just in plastic. A lot better than spending 40, 50 bucks on a kit, huh? So, hope you like this week's video. These are all simple techniques that you can use to make yourself a great structure. Go to the hobby store, get some plastic, get working. That's your New Year's resolution. Don't break this one. You broke last year's, I saw that.